everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. I bet you wonder where we've been. Well, it's a cold day out today, so we can't be outside. Although Sunday was 60. It was in the 60s, and we did get outside for a little while. But when it's winter, we have indoor stuff that we have to do. We've been working on a big project, but I finally got to do some gourds. Now, I started this. This is going to be a spirit gourd. I started this one probably 2 years ago, and I just never got back to it. So I had the bottom part, the body, sort of done. With the colors. And then I had the collar done. Okay. Now, for whatever reason, the collar stayed exactly the color that I made it originally, but the body faded. So I had to try to match the colors that were not faded over here. And I didn't remember which ones I had used. And after a lot of experimentation, and does this one seem to go like that, or did I ended up doing as close as possible. This shiny disc under here is Rick's idea, which is kind of neat. It adds a whole new dimension. This will go up here as a collar, and then this will be the head.
Well, you haven't put a face on it yet.
No, I haven't.
And you haven't given it a name.
No, I can't do that until I have the face. And I won't know the face until I see the hair now. That's good. But I have to add a few more things before I can actually give it a persona.
Now, what are you doing these for?
Well, this particular one I'm going to be giving as a gift. I need two gifts for my high school girls' picnic come June, and this is going to be one of them. Nobody knows yet, so don't tell anybody.
What if anybody sees this video?
Then I'm in trouble, because you're not supposed to know what it is.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so the fun thing about putting together gourd spirit dolls is that I have lots of different things, little things I've collected, sequins, beads. This always reminded me of hair, so I knew I had to have that. These are tiny little gourds with little tall, skinny necks that I could use if I cut off, like if I was using this one, I could cut off that part and I could attach it as an arm, or I could have a Medusa and have these as like lots of little hair things sticking out of somebody's head. That's the fun thing, because you're just putting things together and seeing if it works and seeing what kind of character you can create.
Kind of like your hairdo.
Sort of like that.
Things,
yeah.
Sticking out of your head.
Well, that's why this one looked kind of nice to me.
Well, I suggest you use this, what do you call it?
Yarn.
As a collar on...
Yes, you wanted me to put it around the edge here.
Well, underneath, so it hangs down. Yeah.
Right.
Put it back on.
Now, I'm thinking, one of my thoughts is to take a bead, a golden bead, and put it, hang it on the edge, and have a series of beads along the edge.
Oh, hanging.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or maybe as... adjoining area here
around the head
to give it a right
like
give,
a necklace
to kind of anchor it or give it a necklace thing. So, but that's the fun of it, you know. You can try different things and see which works the best for you. Not done yet. We'll show you when I get done.
So we're gonna do this in stages.
We're gonna have to.
Okay.
Well, I've been thinking over the last couple of days as to what my next step is, how I want to progress, and what I want it to actually turn out to be. I put the beads and the little circle of beads on, glued those on. Now, this looks like it's going to be white, but it isn't. The glue I use is dries so that it's clear. Then I glued this top, the collar, onto the base. Then I'm using this as a stabilizer. So it's going to be sitting on there, but I didn't like just the whole shininess of it. And as I was looking for Easter things last week, I found this old, well, I shouldn't say it's old. I found this ornament for 97 cents at the garden store while I was looking for other things. And I thought, I might be able to use some of that. So I pulled one of these off. It's wire, so it's kind of flexible. And I cut it into pieces and glued them onto the disc. Now again, this looks like it's going to be blobby, but it isn't. It'll dry clear, and it won't show anyway because this is going on top of it. Now my husband is very concerned because now I only have 8 points of connection when I glue this down. But I can make my glue line thicker so that it'll actually sit into the glue. And again, it's
fill
clear.
In the gap.
It's clear, right? But I needed something else to anchor it down in my mind, visually anchor it down. And I knew we had beads down in our collection. So I'm thinking I'm going to anchor it down by gluing these beads on, and I'll put the whole of the bead so it won't be showing. That way the beads will be glued to the bottom as well as to the body.
Are you ready to glue one down?
That's another point of attachment. Well, I haven't glued down the base yet, so I can't do that yet.
Well, you could if you started to put all your beads in place, because they would be where it would go back inside. In other words,
But if I want to anchor it by putting glue on the bottom and the side so that it anchors the bottom, the body down, I can't do that yet.
But you can glue it to the bead, too, to the side of the bead and to the bottom.
I will once I get my body glued to the disc. See, we have our different approaches of how to do this.
Well, here's my other concern is...
Yes.
Lynn calls this the back.
That is the back. See, because when I put
that. And there's nothing there.
No. It doesn't need to have something there. See, this is the head, and this will be looking this way. And if it were sitting on a shelf or even on a table, usually you don't just see the back. The back is just going to be the natural gourd color.
Lenny, that's like sweeping dirt under the rug. It's
I don't see any dirt here at all. It's clean. Everything's clean, just like the head is not all decorated.
Well,
this is just
the bald head I could see.
And you can see the different plays of the light.
Is this a boy or a girl?
I believe it's going to be a girl.
Oh, boy. Yes. And she has a naked back?
Yep.
Oh, very exotic.
I don't know. I may change my mind and put something on the back.
I still think you need if you're gonna just leave it blank.
Yes.
It would be cool to have a door back there, just a drawing of a door, that would intrigue people and
the
think.
Door
gee,
to look under her skirt?
No.
I don't think so.
She's a robot.
No, she is not.
Have to get in there to fix her gears and oil them every now and then.
No, she's a spirit doll, and she doesn't need to have any gears.
Okay.
The beads themselves that are going to be in the very front are going to be lying so that the hole doesn't show. But I didn't think that would be enough just for the rest of the body. So I cut some of those, my husband's calling them spears, that I put on the disc, and I'm thinking I'm going to put those in the bead, glue them into the bead, and then they will go along the side. And those will go all along the back.
To cover up her bareness?
Yeah. And then the front will not have these little spears. The front will just be the plain bead on its side so the hole doesn't show. Now, in order to do that, I need to have glue that will go inside the hole. So I'm using...
Well, either that or you could put it on the end of the spear.
Mm-hmm. Well, you have to see how it goes.
Have to test and see which works. Otherwise, it's going to blob over.
It won't matter because it's clear. Okay, so then that will have to dry.
Got me all choked up.
I know. You shouldn't make fun of your wife.
No, never.
Artistic endeavors. So I will have a bunch of those, and then those will go along the back.
Hmm. So mm-hmm. She won't be naked.
You keep saying that.
Well, she's bare back there. Getting down to bare bones. Hmm. That's all you can say? Hmm? Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's like brain surgery.
It is. Delicate.
Oh. And how many of these do you have to make?
I don't know yet.
So have you come up with a name yet for this one?
Nope, I don't have a face yet either.
Okay.
The hardest part for me is coming up with a face. A face that I feel works with the actual body. So a couple of my sketches are here. This one kind of looks too happy. And this one's kind of plain. That one looks like a potato head. And these, when I was thinking of doing a mushroom, a mustache, just looked too comical. I don't have a face yet. Still working on the face idea.
You're going to have earrings, jewelry?
Maybe. I don't know. I'll have to wait and see.
Okay.
What I'm going to do now is actually glue the body of the gourd doll onto my base. I'm putting a goodly amount right inside along the edge, but not on the rim itself yet. And that way, as it dribbles down, it can make contact and anchor it more securely. Now I've marked where I want the front to go and where this actually has to sit by scoring it before I started gluing. Yep, looks pretty good. Good boy, a little closer, but no, it's kind of setting already, so that's good. The next gluing step will be to put on these. And I intend to put glue on the bottom and also on the side. So when it sits in here, it'll make contact with the bottom and with the base, which is another way of not only hiding the glue that will seep down, but also anchoring it a little bit more. Now I'm thinking I'll use the stickiest glue for the beads. And see, this glue does not come out. That's why I have to have... The only thing wrong with these is probably, especially this very tacky glue, is it should be in a shorter, wider jar maybe, because you have to end up using something big and long and sometimes awkward. So let's just look how this looks. Let me turn it so you can see. All right, so you see I anchored at the bottom and I anchored it on the back.
Okay.
So now it's just a matter of this one will be not only anchored at the bottom and the back, but also to the one next to it. You know, and you kind of do it little by little and see how it's working out. Okay, so that's what I'm going to be doing. I settled on a face, and then because I gave it a girl face, I gave it some earrings, and the earrings will match what's going around the base. So they're in the process of drying right now, so I can't put her anywhere yet. Two more to go. I get the bottom. I get one side. And then a little more on this side. There you go. Now, if you can just imagine this without the white showing, that's how it'll look. Except for the very front where I have the ones without the spikes.
Now, is there a reason why you did that way, without the spikes?
Just to make sure it looked like it was the front. It just emphasized the front more.
Okay.
And that's how she'll look. While sitting here contemplating and waiting for things to dry, we started playing with adding more beads than just the one that we had at the bottom. And that way we get to give it an even more intricate pattern. So we're thinking of adding more, a couple beads on each side here, like two, and then one, and two over here, just to give it kind of a wavy, scallopy pattern.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, it's turning out kind of nice. I like it. But see, this is a disc, so it has the hole up through the middle.
Yep.
And once we put the head on, obviously, there won't be access to
that. And what are you thinking of adding inside?
Well, since it's a spirit doll, I was thinking that, with Rick's idea, to put a secret message inside, a spiritual message inside, before I put the head on. No one will know what it is, but it'll be in there and it'll have its own power.
Very cool. I like it. I think that base, too, will give it a little more stability.
There you go, Tilly. Looking for the face that called to me that went with the hair, and that's what I came up with. And because of that face, then I knew it was going to be a girl spirit doll, and that's why I gave her some earrings, which are still drying.
Now, you've already given her a name.
Tilly.
Tilly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, why did that name come to you?
I don't know. It just popped in my mind.
Okay. I know you like to have the bear back, but that's okay.
No, the back isn't bare anymore.
Oh, it isn't?
No.
Oh, you've been busy.
All right, so you see that.
Now, you were going to put a little necklace around her neck?
Yes, eventually, once I get everything in place, this will go around her neck, and that way it will kind of anchor the head better to the collar. Hmm. And it goes with the design on the outside. Okay, and then in the back, I continued the little splotchy things that are actually shapes left on the gourd from the mildewing process, the molding process.
Now, I know that you have not told any of the viewers where this base comes from or even where the cap came from.
Well, first of all, the head is an egg gourd. So they grow in this egg shape. Then this part was from another gourd. This top part was from another gourd. The bottom was pretty much damaged. It's not a real thick. The gourds that we grow up here aren't really thick like the ones that you can get down south because our growing season is so much shorter. So the rest of the gourd that was connected to this collar part was ruined, but I was able to save the top.
Was that the base, though, itself? Was that like from a goose-type gourd?
No, the base is a snake gourd.
A snake gourd.
Right.
Yeah. Okay.
And I've cut the snake gourds. Now, the snake gourds can get like this long.
Kind of like you're telling a fishing story, right?
And sometimes they're very twisted and sometimes they're straight. It depends on, you know, if they were touching the ground, then they might be more of a spiral. If they were lying straight, they would be more straight. So we were at a garage sale one time, and this woman had all these snake gourds lying around, and I said, you know, are you selling those? And she said, yes. So I, in my mind, I'm thinking, ooh, those would be good bodies. So when we got home, I cut one up into sections. So now I have a bunch of bodies that I can use. I just have to attach the egg gourd to the head.
Would you be so kind as to bring out one of your snake gourds and some of the cutout pieces just so people can see where it actually came from in case they don't speak English?
Oh, I'd have to go out on the porch and get it because that's where they are.
Okay.
I wanted to clarify exactly what the original parts look like, perhaps. This collar, like I was saying, came from the top of a gourd that I wasn't really able to use, and obviously not this one. But you can see this has thin walls, and it didn't make it through the curing process and being outside all winter and drying. You can see the seeds are still in there. And I could take a cut off of here and make a different collar for another gourd. This is how ugly they get. There are some that get even more ugly with the skin peeling up.
Yeah, but you can see the patterns. That's
exactly.
On the
this is the mold that forms, and then eventually you just take a brush and you scrub that off, and then eventually you rinse it with bleach water and let it dry real thoroughly, and you'll end up with a beautiful beige color gourd. Now the body part is the snake gourd that I was talking about. This is a snake gourd right here. And the lady we bought it from, I believe, varnished it because they usually aren't this shiny.
I think it was her daughter's.
Mm-hmm. But you can see the patterns. I mean, those are just gorgeous patterns on there. And that's all formed because of the mold that forms on there.
So you just took your saw.
I took my saw and I just cut sections, and that became the body.
Now that saw is pretty delicate, right?
This is a gourd saw, specifically made for gourds. And it's from the caning shop, and my husband was very sweet one year and got this for me.
Turn it on once.
It's kind of loud. But it's perfect for making the precise cuttings that you want. It's easy to guide along and get into the grooves or do the circles or whatever you want to do. It also came with a sander. So if you wanted to actually do sanding on the gourd itself without having to sit there with a sandpaper, that would be that. And it comes with the sand pads. And then this is a drill for drilling holes in case you wanted to put in decorations, or you wouldn't have to drill all the way through. You could just use it as a Dremel and just make designs in the shell of the gourd.
So it comes as a little gourd
kit.
It
comes as a whole kit, right. And then you can adjust the speed. So you don't have to go racing through, you can take your time. When I work on my gourd spirit dolls, it takes me a long time, mostly because I keep getting interrupted by other things like life, but also because I need time to think about what I want to do next. We decided that as we had these little spikes sticking up, it was just too plain. And so we added a pattern of beads at different levels. And then I glued the top one to not only to the body, but then also to the one below it. And to keep them in tight so they'd stick to the body, I had to tie them in. Come on, scissors. Some tough material here. Okay. So I'm pleased with that. And then I started looking at it and I decided I don't like the way this looks. And that's why I will be taking off the tops. Oops, carefully your eyeballs. See, that looks better, doesn't it?
Yep.
Okay, so that's one of the things I have to do. And so it's just a matter of going along for each one. The other thing I have to do is attach the head, but before I can attach the head, I have to put the spirit message inside. No, I'm not going to show it to you. But I'm going to put it inside, and it will then be in there permanently because I will glue the head on. So there it is, inside. No peeking. I would like to position her head so it's kind of tilting upward a little bit in a positive view of life. But they're, because they're gourds and they have their own shapes, it doesn't match everywhere along the edge. There are gaps where her head doesn't quite meet. And that's why I'm going to be putting on this little
necklace.
And it will fill in that gap once I get it glued in. And not only then will it coordinate the gold with this and this, but it'll also serve as a stabilizer for her head.
She's turning out lovely.
Thank you. And then she should be done.
And her name is Tilly?
Tilly. I don't know why, but that's what came up.
Dilly Dilly.
Well, I took all of these down, and I like the way that looks better. And now for the head. I've been trying to decide how I'm going to put the head on, and I think I have to put the glue on the collar itself because I don't know exactly where on the head it'll have to sit.
And what kind of glue are you using?
This is the Fast Grip.
Tacky glue.
Mm-hmm. It's very tacky. I'm going to make sure I have it not only a little way around the edge, but also on the seam area where it will actually come in contact probably the most.
Well, plus you're going to need some for the bead necklace.
Right.
Oh, it'll already be in place then.
Yes, it should be. I can figure out how to do that.
So are you ever going to tell me the secret message inside?
No. No one knows.
Oh. Well, knowing you, I know it's very inspirational.
Mm-hmm. I got it out of one of your books.
Oh.
And because it's going to dry clear, I can be a little generous.
Should have got you some of that Gorilla Glue.
No, that expands and it doesn't dry clear.
I know.
Okay, now I've lost my point of where I thought I wouldn't need the beads. Oh, well.
Life is an experiment.
At least it's not brain surgery. Okay, that seems to be working better. Okay, now you see my dilemma here. I have to know exactly how many beads I need and then be able to cut it off and tie it. And then I'll worry about where I'm going to hide it after my tie after it's done. I think that's where it's going to be. Maybe I'll just leave it here until it dries.
Yeah, why not?
I could always have a little ponytail hanging down. That looks pretty good. I hope it doesn't dribble. But there you go, Tilly. You're attached to your body, finally.
Now that Tilly has all of her pieces in place, they're glued, they're dry, I'm happy with them. The only thing I have left to do is to glue her to this base. Now you might say, well, why do you even have a base? Well, I think it just for stability. Some of my other ones that I've done in the past are not stable. In fact, I dropped this one twice, knocked it over twice today, just putting it up on the table. This comes from DVD discs. This was the spindle in the middle, which we cut off so that it would fit inside. And I'm not going to be able to use the top because obviously it's not tall enough to transport. But I'll have a different way of transporting. So the only thing I want to do now is just...
Well, the other thing too is you spray painted this.
Yes, we did. We made it beautiful just by putting a little bit of gold spray paint on.
And the reason you're gluing this down is
just to give it more stability and to keep roving eyes from looking inside. I've put a spiritual message inside. No one knows what it is except me. And that's the way it has to be. Why am I doing this? Why would I put something inside? When you're gardening and when you're creating art, you're putting some of yourself into it. And it's a great feeling when you're creating, and it's a great feeling when you're gardening. And I think the positive energy of me doing this and also putting in a positive message just makes it glow. So I'm going to be very happy with it, and I hope whoever gets this one at our party will also appreciate it.
Now you're also going to make a second one too, right?
Yes, I will be making a second one. I have some feathers that a very sweet viewer sent me from her bird when she heard our bird in the back, and when she also saw that I used some of our bird's feathers on this one. She sent me some red ones from her bird. I haven't used them yet, but I will be.
Now, no birds were harmed in the making of those, capturing of those feathers, right?
They're just the ones that fall off all by themselves.
Okay.
So I think Tilly is finished, and I'll send her on her way proudly. These are some of the spirit dolls and just the fun things I've made over the years out of gourds. I know we have a four-part video on the making of the sea turtle. That was a lot of fun. It took me a long time, but it was great, and it has a bobblehead. They're fun for me, and I get to use my creativity, like using pieces of the gourd vine itself, and the feathers, of course, just pieces of, again, the gourd plant. It's fun. And even my little guinea pig down there. I have an affinity for guinea pigs.
So when the snow flies and people are always asking, well, what do you do during the summer or the winter time when you're not gardening?
Right.
Well, this is one of your passions.
This is one of the things. Right. I like doing it, and I end up with things that I'm happy with, usually. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up, because it always helps support our Wisconsin Garden mission of presenting videos. If you've done things with gourds or things from your garden, we'd love to hear about it and would love to see pictures of them. Also, if you'd like to comment, love to hear comments. And if you want to become part of our garden family, please subscribe. Remember, the little button is right over there. Thank you for watching. We appreciate it.
So, have you any idea what the second one's going to look like yet?
I have no idea. I won't know until I see gourds.
Well, Cecil will have to wait until that time, I guess.
Okay.
Turn them upside down once. Yeah, he really did come from a gourd.
Yes, he did. It's kind of dusty, too. Of course, that's just stardust.
Connect with us on YouTube.